Every living soul must one day depart this world. That is how the balance is maintained. But there are those who seek to shatter that balance. It is then that I must come down to Earth. Remember me, Detective? It is I, Death. Sorry to drop by uninvited, but I'm in dire need of your expertise. You see, a delicate balance exists between life and death. I am the one who maintains that balance. Several souls have shattered that balance by running from me when their time was due. If they do not die soon, other souls will not be born, and a rift will open in time itself. Unfortunately, they have somehow hidden themselves from me, and I cannot risk punishing an innocent soul. That is why I've come to you. You know this world well. You must not only find them, but find evidence proving their guilt. My most powerful tools are at your disposal. I see you're admiring my magic sphere. It teleports you instantly to anywhere on the globe. One soul escaped from me in Paris. I would start your search there. I'll be watching.
Not again. She ran away with that boyfriend of hers. Can't she see how dangerous Paris is now? Oh, sorry, I didn't introduce myself. I'm Gerard, and that was Zoe, my niece. Ah, you're that detective. You're investigating the missing women, yes? Everyone is leaving town because of it. It's just not safe anymore. But for some reason, Zoe won't leave. You must make her see reason. I just have this feeling that she could be next. Look, I've got to catch my train, but please take this book. I dropped a few pages in my rush, but you should be able to find them. It could help your investigation. Good luck!
Thank you. Zoe, what made you decide to leave the scene at the peak of your singing career?
For so long, singing has been my life, my greatest dream. But all of that disappeared in an instant.
Did it have anything to do with your health problems?
I'll say this. There are things even more precious than passion and fame. Ah, so you're that detective. Thank you for returning my purse. I lost it during that commotion. So many people have left because of those girls who vanished. But my dear Leonard and I refuse to panic. We could never leave Paris. Ugh, you simply must meet Leonard. He'd be such a help to your investigation. You should be at home. Pardon me, I'm feeling ill.
Greetings, Detective. Welcome to my home. I'm Leonard Gauthier. I believe you've already met my darling Zoe.
Leonard, this detective is investigating those missing women and wants to search your home for clues. I know you have nothing to hide and would be happy to help.
Certainly, my dear. I won't interfere with your investigation, Detective. I'm at your service.
Your investigation seems to be going well, Detective. I see you found the victims. Here, take my medallion. It will allow you to talk to the dead.
Thank you.
There once lived an orphan in Paris, but he was by no means poor. His parents had died rich, leaving him a fortune. But without anyone to love him, he grew resentful and greedy, especially when his doctors told him he did not have long to live. Young Leonard often visited his family tomb. He enjoyed walking through the dark corridors, his mind fixated on his death. One day, he discovered a diary with "For the Poor Boy" written on the cover. This diary contained a terrible power. Whenever Leonard wrote a girl's name on its pages, she instantly fell in love with him, and he could drain her vitality. With these dark powers at his command, he could sustain immortality.
Thank you.
No! Leonard, is it true? Are they all dead?
They were nobody, Zoe. I've put their lives to good use. You've never tasted immortality, but I have, and it is so good.
Leonard Galtier, you stand accused of stealing other lives to prolong your own.
Who the hell are you?
Death has come, and justice shall be done.
No one tells me what to do.
We've only barely apprehended this criminal, and now another name has vanished from my list, jeopardizing the balance once more. My friend, you are the only one I trust to see this to its end. Please continue your investigation. This person was last seen in London. I cannot join you there, but I will be watching.
The Farrells lived happily until the day Benjamin had a sudden heart attack. Desperate to save her beloved, Emily vowed to save Benjamin at any cost. She secretly experimented on a dying girl, hoping she could find a way to revive Benjamin. Unfortunately, her calculations were incorrect, and the little girl died. Emily began to despair. Until someone interfered and affected the outcome.
Please help me.
Leave me alone!
No! No!
Thank you.
You're just in time to help. I'm Emily Farrell, one of the scientists here. I'm one of the few who decided to remain in London no matter what happened. You're a detective, right? That monster who was strapped was following me. We have a medicine in the pharmacy lab that should change that monster back into human. This bottle should help you as well. Listen, I don't have time to explain. We must settle this as soon as possible. This code will allow you access to the lab.
Thank you. horrible lurks here. I was once a carefree girl, but when I fell deathly ill, I was brought to this hospital. One day, during visiting hours, a strange lady arrived, claiming she could cure me. Then she put something in my medicine. All I remember is the pain. But now I know why. She was testing a drug for her husband. It didn't work, though. It killed me. She killed me. Thanks for listening, Detective. Maybe this will help you.
We will be together again, Benjamin. I'll make sure of it.
Emily Farrell, who loved her husband more than life itself, could not accept his death. Utilizing all of her skills, she concocted a serum that would bring her love back to life. Emily ignored her sworn ethics, testing it on terminal patients. Few survived her treatment. At first, Benjamin seemed to be his normal self, but it didn't last long. A minute mistake in the chemical structure caused Benjamin to transform into a monster. The price of resurrecting life was too high.
Why? Why did you bring me back?
What have I done?
Oh.
Benjamin, take this. It will ease the pain.
Emily, forgive me.
Emily Farrell, by bringing your husband back to life, you threatened hundreds of innocent lives, shattering the balance of this world.
I didn't realize I couldn't lose my love.
You will be punished for the misery you caused. Everyone must face death. Emily and Benjamin's story ended in tragedy, but her punishment was just. The balance must be maintained. Another name has vanished from my list, and it has been replaced with the names of those who should be alive. You must go to Prague quickly and stop this criminal.
What do you want? Don't lose your cool. I've got nothing to hide. Oh, bummer. This is really uncomfortable. But did you really catch me? You can't prove anything.
Good heavens! Thank you for saving me. I didn't expect to get attacked on the bridge so early in the morning, that's for sure. I remember who attacked me. It was Alfred Kristen. I always thought he was weird, but never violent. Prague's been so unsettling since those people vanished. Oh, sorry for babbling on. You must be in a hurry, but could you help me clean up the mess Alfred left? I need to gather my flowers. Thank you, Detective. You really helped me out. Feel free to look around my store. Maybe you'll find something you can use.
Thank you.
You're smarter than you look. I can't deny it. It's mine. But that proves nothing. You want to search my house? Go ahead, if you can. Come on, search me too. You won't find anything. You won't find anything. Thank you. Hey, is that from my diary? Have a little decency, Detective. That's private. Give it back. I was chosen, initiated. Do you understand? I have powers you don't understand. Are you going to search me again? The one who gave me this power wasn't human. You're treading in deep water, Detective. Don't be in such a hurry. You don't have any evidence. You can't convict me.
Alfred Kristen dreamed of designing the perfect fragrance. He craved fame and recognition, but he lacked talent. Success seemed impossible. However, Alfred refused to accept his fate. He swore that his name would become famous worldwide.
Anna and I were killed by Alfred Kristen. But he's simply a pawn in a game being played by higher powers. Be careful. This will help your investigation.
Working tirelessly night after night, Alfred searched for the perfect fragrance. But his efforts were in vain. Until one day, when Alfred met a mysterious woman who told him a terrifying secret. The secret ingredient he was missing to create the perfect fragrance was human blood. She then gave him the Philosopher's Stone so that he could turn blood into a divine perfume. Alfred's fate was sealed.
Accused of several murders. You killed them for their blood? Humans can be so strange. Wait, what is this? Am I?
My dear Death, it's been too long.
Chaos, I should have known that you were behind this.
Don't you see? It was all a ruse to lure you out and take my revenge at last.
Leave now. You do not belong in this world.
How exasperating! I left Paris to enjoy a peaceful life in Prague. I certainly wasn't expecting this. It's me, Gerard, Zoe's uncle. Imagine bumping into you here. Did you see all this? What rotten luck! That ancient prophecy is coming true! Wait, what's that? Isn't that the Medallion of Death? You simply must let me examine it.
This conflict is part of an ancient prophecy. Long ago, Chaos appeared. She had immense power, equal to that of Death. But their philosophies differed greatly. Chaos was ruthless, reveling in the destruction of order. But Death held rigidly to the rules, seeking justice for all humans. That's why they're at odds now. Death prevented Chaos from meddling in Earth's affairs. That medallion you're holding is actually part of the isolation transmitter. Chaos, driven by discord, has returned to take her revenge on Death. There is only one way to banish her. It seems the ancient prophecy is coming true. Detective, you're the only one who can stop this. Please, take my medallion and go to the archives. Good luck, my friend. Long ago, Chaos came down to Earth. Her powers were immense, and she destroyed everything in her path. She showed no mercy. She held her head high in arrogance as she unleashed devastation across the lands. Death could not stand idly by as the order of our world shattered. Thus, death confronted Chaos. Realizing Chaos would destroy humanity, he searched for the isolation transmitter and used it to send Chaos to isolation, a realm of immaterial existence. But Chaos vowed to break free. She kept her promise. Now, it's time to send her back.
What are you gonna do? Swing your pointy stick at me? That's impossible. No!
Excellent. It is finished. All of the innocent souls shall return to life. It is the least I can do. The balance has been restored, thanks to you. Now, I must return to my duties. Farewell, my friend.